So we've done two basics. Let's get on to something a little bit more fun. The next one that I'd like to do is to push down certain apps and extensions from the Google Chrome store so all of my staff have the applications and the extensions that we need. So let's go ahead and open up the Chrome Web Store. So if you've not been to the Chrome Web Store before, this is what it looks like. So inside the Google Chrome Web Store, this is where we can search for apps, extensions, and any plugins for G Suite. Now, you probably have a couple that you're using and you want to use right across the company, like maybe LastPass or maybe Screencastify is a good one for recording videos. There's another one that we use here, which is called Awesome Screenshot, which is great for taking screenshots. This one I absolutely love called Clipboard History. I'm not going to open it because it shows the last 10 things that you copied. There's probably passwords and stuff in there. But let's say, for example, we want to push down Clipboard History to everyone's machine. So I'll go to Clipboard History and just show you guys what that app looks like, just in case you're interested in making use of that one yourself. Here we go, Clipboard History Pro. So let's go and set up a policy to push down this plugin for everyone. So what's going to happen is inside your plugins, if I open up my plugins here, they're called extensions. Inside my extensions, you can see that I can switch on or off any of these that I wish that I have installed myself. But some of these are actually grayed out. I'm not actually able to switch them off. And that's because someone has deployed them via policy. They've actually been pushed down. And you can see Google even puts a little office building there in orange that says added by policy, which means that it's been pushed down by someone else apart from myself. So let's go ahead and set this up inside our policies. This one is actually called Force Installed Apps. So Google's now moved this to a page called Apps and Extensions. So let's go to the Apps and Extensions page, and this is where we're going to install it. So there's a number of different apps that Google has, and this can get a little bit confusing because Google has Android apps that you can access on, let's say, a mobile phone, and using Android for work, you can actually automatically force install Android applications on anyone's Android phone. You can also force install iOS applications on staff Apple phones. Now, we're not covering Active Directory and mobile device management in this video, but we will cover that in a future video. But Google has other apps as well. You have the Chrome apps, so they're the apps that run on the Chrome browser, and also Chrome extensions as well, which are these ones that appear in the little top right-hand corner. So when you're deploying these apps inside the G Suite panel, it can get a bit confusing because there's different types of apps. Now, Google are actually getting rid of their Chrome apps. Now, I don't want to confuse those with extensions. All of these extensions are staying, but Chrome apps, which are Chrome applications that open in a separate window. If you've used one like maybe WhatsApp or Google Keep is another separate one that open up in a separate window. Those are actually moving away, and Google are forcing everyone to develop their apps either in the web or in the sidebar, like you've seen in your Gmail. There's applications and add-ons in the sidebar now, or moving to an extension format. And so where there may be apps, there's now just going to be extensions inside of Google Chrome, and obviously you'll still have your Android apps on the mobile device as well. So if I've completely confused you, don't worry about that. Let's just go through some basics. If you're interested in rolling out something like LastPass or Clipboard History Pro or Screencastify, we can make it really easy to push that out to everyone. So you can see here that we've got a number of apps which are already pushed down to our team. And so if I want to add something and push it down to everyone, I just need to click the plus button here, and it's going to give me different options. So I can add from the Google Play Store, I can add based on the ID, I can add based on the URL. We're actually going to go to the Chrome Web Store because that's the easiest place to find these add-ons. And then inside the Chrome Web Store, it'll let me do a little search here. So for example, if I wanted to do a clipboard history, I can search for clipboard history, and it's going to allow me to open up that tool. So once we've selected one of these extensions that we'd like to roll out, it's probably not going to let me roll this one out because I've already actually included this for my team, but let's just see what happens. Okay, it is going to allow me to add it. And so from here, you can see there's a few different options. We can allow install, we can force install, we can force install and pin, which means it's going to be forced to appear up there, or we can block, which means it's not going to be allowed to be available at all. And pretty straightforward, if I want to remove one of those, I can go ahead and then remove it. So I just hit the bin icon and then I hit save. There we go. So what we've done is we've taken an extension from the Chrome Web Store, we've added it to the policy, it's pushed it down to everyone who's in that organizational group, which at the top, we're just pushing these down to everyone in the business. And then everyone is pretty much instantly going to have that extension push down to their browser. If you decide to push down LastPass and you want your team to be using LastPass for their passwords, you may choose to disable the built-in password manager and the built-in form fill, particularly if you're working in a business in the financial services industry or in the medical services industry, any kind of like healthcare. You've got pretty strict rules around customer privacy and making sure that customer information is well protected. Now, if, for example, someone is using form filling software, you know, the software and the setting inside of Chrome that helps you to fill out your forms when you're working with them. Let's say you're filling out forms online and it's just saving all of the entries there in like a little database. That is actually a breach of the Australian privacy laws. What happens is if you've got, let's say, an online practice management software that you're using and Chrome is auto-filling that customer information as you're capturing it, that's actually storing patient information inside of Google Chrome. Now, that's one example for healthcare, but if you're using LastPass for your password, then there's really no point for you to be also using Google Chrome to store passwords locally as well, because we want to make sure that they're stored in an encrypted vault inside of LastPass. It's a bit more secure than just saving them inside of Chrome. So another one that I like to do is to go into user settings and to actually disable the password manager inside of Chrome. And we can also disable the form fills as well. So let's search for password. Here we go. So password manager, and I've got that currently set to never allow the use of password manager. So this is not talking about allowing the use of LastPass, it's talking about the built-in password manager for Google Chrome. So that's an important one if you're using LastPass to go ahead and switch that off. And then there's another one which is called, I think it's called form fill. Let's just search for the word fill. Here we go, form autofill, and I've also switched that off, never autofill forms. So if you'd like to increase the security for your staff, restricting those options makes it a little bit easier to do. Setting the homepage for all users, that's another one that I love. If you want to set the homepage for everyone's browser to, let's say, for example, your intranet website, currently I've allowed everyone to configure it themselves, but if you want to set that to a particular URL, then you can automatically set everybody's homepage to the same URL. And so that might be useful for your Google site, for your intranet, where all your systems and processes are. Go ahead and pop that in there. Okay, if you're interested in our concierge service, what our team will do is actually help implement all of these for you. And so if you want to set up the URLs, if you want to set up the links maybe, if you want to push down some different plugins, if you want to have a chat to our team about what plugins that we recommend you implement, well, then you can just drop a message into our Facebook account, into our Facebook page at itGenius, and our team will respond and help you out with that. It's not really great use of your time to be dicking around in the admin panel for hours at a time. If you're kind of in and out, then yeah, maybe, but really it's best to delegate these kind of things to someone else. So whether you delegate it to your team or you delegate it to a team like ours to actually help you out getting these things implemented and maintained, that can save you a lot of time, and it's an extremely affordable service. Now, if you're not currently a customer of itGenius and you just want to send some love our way, then please go ahead and switch your billing into us. If you buy your G Suite licenses through us, it doesn't cost you anything extra, but it does, of course, help us out, and we give you some pretty cool perks for that. So we'll do user setups via our concierge service, and we'll also help out with basic support as well. And of course, if anything does go wrong, then we've already got backend access to your account if your billing is through us, so we can effectively support you. From time to time, we have customers who have businesses that we come across who get locked out of their G Suite accounts, and that's obviously pretty distressing if they've got all their staff unable to work because they're locked out. And if we have your billing through us, then we have a way of getting back into your account no matter what happens. Sometimes Google will shut you down for spamming or for going over quotas, or sometimes just seemingly randomly. And if we have access to your account, then we can always help you out. There's no extra cost to be billing through us. And so if you do, it certainly helps us out, but also you get some extra perks for yourself as well. And I look forward to catching you in the next stream. I'll see you later. Until the next one. Cheers.